if I can sum up the published and verbal opinions of my great father-in-law Zatzal, Rav Moshe Feinstein, he held halacha lemaase. A neighbor of mine, who was a Chabadnik, needed a lung transplant. Actually, at a time when they couldn't do lung transplants, so you had to do a heart lung transplant, because they knew how to connect the heart, they didn't know how to cut the lungs and reconnect them. She had a heart lung transplant in Pittsburgh. After consulting with the Lubavitcher Rebbe Zatzal, who sent her to Rav Moshe, and Rav Moshe approved the heart lung transplant there, declaring the donor dead. Rabbi Feinstein wouldn't allow that kind of rationalization, that the donor could be killed in order to save the life of a Jewish patient. The opinion of Rabbi Feinstein is recorded in the Igros Moshe. There was a tshuva, a responsa, that he wrote to me. It didn't concern organ donation. It concerned when can you stop the ventilator once a patient was declared brainstem dead. And there was no issue of organ donation there. The issue was simply, can you remove the ventilator? And Rabbi said, of course. Once you can show that he's not breathing independently, then you remove the ventilator. Here we didn't have another motivation, namely to save another human life, just to bury this one. Strangely enough, one of the opponents to brainstem death determination had the lack of integrity to make a statement in print that Rabbi Feinstein's son, my brother-in-law, David Feinstein Shlita, had said that his father never approved of brainstem death. That went around the Jewish world. And what was missing was a little integrity of someone calling Reb David to ask, is it so? No one did. As at least the person did not, and kept on lecturing and publishing in print. Finally, I called my brother. I said, what's going on here? He said, you know how many times we discussed this with our father. There's no issue. He's printed. And he wrote a letter to the opposition, which was delivered by hand. Didn't change. The following lecture at a conference, the same repetition of a canard of this lie, until Reb David wrote a second letter, and where he stated, my father said, a person is dead if his brain doesn't allow him to breathe autonomically, even if the heart is beating. I put underlined there. That quieted down the rumor, but never received an apology or retraction from those people who spread the rumor. And there's where halacha is debased by lack of integrity. Behind all halachic decision is the absolute integrity of the decisor. Once that integrity is questioned, then the halacha is denigrated in the process. The first opposition came about when the statement was made, Rabbi Feinstein never wrote such a tshuva, that it was printed by me in the Igros Moshe. I responded to that, whoever asked the question, by sending him the handwritten tshuva, as Rabbi Feinstein wrote all his tshuvas on this lined paper. So you have his handwriting. No one else could do so. And then the second issue came about when someone with in an unconscionable way declared that Rabbi Feinstein's son had denied that his father ever had approved a brainstem death. So Rav David Feinstein Shtita wrote a letter which was delivered by hand to the one who had started that rumor without much success, because the rumor was repeated. And finally, Rav David wrote a second letter in which there he said, "I heard from my father that the person whose brainstem death is dead, even though the heart is beating there." That seemed to quiet down the opposition finally. And here, possibly, it's just, this is the picture of the lamb that was born after the sheep was decapitated. Rabbi Feinstein received a request for clarification whether organ donation is a mitzvah from Rabbi Weiss Zatzal when he was Rav in Manchester. Rav Weiss then became the head of the Beis Din Tzedek in Yerushalayim. And Rav Weiss received an answer. So happens that I was at that time invited to Manchester to give a graduation address. I delivered it by hand. And Rabbi Feinstein wrote, and it's found in Igros Moshe, the second chelek of Yoredeya, the very last response from there is written to Rabbi Weiss, in which he says organ donation being, not discussing brain death, but organ donation per se, is a great mitzvah and should be done. To which Rabbi Weiss wrote a response, which I delivered by hand back to Rabbi Feinstein, saying, "But you realize that families suffer great anguish over the thought of a loved one being mutilated. And the halacha, it's a broad principle, an umbrella principle, halacha does not require you to suffer anguish in performing a mitzvah." This is Rabbi Weiss's response. Therefore, you say it's a mitzvah to give an organ, to allow organ donation, but the family will suffer anguish. Money you're supposed to spend to do a mitzvah, but not anguish. Only two mitzvahs require you to suffer. That's circumcision, mila, and Yom Kippur. To which Rabbi Feinstein answered, also published in that response, "Indeed, you're correct that the halacha does not require you to suffer anguish to perform a mitzvah. But don't you realize that the mitzvah is not to feel any anguish when you're saving a human life? That's the main mitzvah," he said. "The mitzvah says, don't you be anguished. You're saving a human life. Nothing could give you greater joy than that." Unfortunately, the organ donor card, so-called, attached to the license is inadequate. It allows too much leeway. What we need is an organ donor card that specifies, yes, organ donation is my will, but under supervision of my rabbi, so that one, how an organ is removed. I'll give you a quick example. I had a question from a fellow of all places in Minnesota who's a Baal Tshuva, and he's an ophthalmologist, and he just got a contract to do the corneal transplants, corneal harvesting for transplant purposes. However, so he came to being a Baal Tshuva, he didn't know, is it permissible for a religious Jew to remove the cornea of a dead patient? So yes, the halacha allows corneal transplants because suma choshuv kemes, blindness is a tantamount to death, therefore it's like pikuach nefesh. I said, "Tell me how you do it." He says, "Well, I just take out the whole eye and I put it in the freezer, and then at some later time, I and others will remove the cornea." I said, "No, you can't do that. That's nivul ames. You're doing more than necessary." He says, "Well, that's how they want it." I said, "Fine, so tell them that you can't do it." Well, a week passes by, he calls me back again. He said, no, they won't allow him. They want it done this way, take out the eye, and then, because then others could do it as well. Others could do it, remove the cornea. I said, fine, said, you can't do it. He had a call from him a week after that. He said, okay. They discussed it with their pastor there. And he said, yes, he understands the ethical point that is unnecessary mutilation. And therefore, you can remove the cornea just, even though it'll take him longer, you have to pay him more for doing it, et cetera, et cetera. So that there's a way to take an organ too. A properly designed organ donor card is absolutely part of a mitzvah. It's one thing to say, yes, I want to give an organ, and then not have the permission that is necessary to be signed and available when, God forbid, a person can become a donor. Therefore, certainly people who want to do the mitzvah should carry an organ donor card. And since after death there's no danger to life of the donor, it becomes an absolute mitzvah. In my opinion, not a donor, but an obligation. The concept of a donation is a voluntary donation. Blood transfusion, when needed, is life-saving, and someone who can then be a blood donor has no choice. He can or cannot. The halacha obligates him to do so, since there is no risk to the donor. That doesn't apply to kidney transplant from a live donor or liver transplant, as we discussed before. But post-death, post-life, when a person has died already, where there's no danger to the donor, then absolute obligation exists. Unfortunately, our rabbonim are not coming up strong enough to let them understand that just like it's an obligation to wear tzitzis and to make kiddush, it's also an obligation to save a human life.
And to carry an organ donor card.
Signing an organ donor card announces to God, I'm prepared to do a mitzvah. Kodesh Baruch Hu grants us Machshava Tova, Kodesh Baruch Hu Metzal for Lamase. A good thought is treated as a good deed. So even if that person will never have to be a donor, the idea that he signed the donor card already gives him credit upstairs. And nothing like credit upstairs to ward off the evil eye. The medical community has suffered a great insult in the protocol for organ donation. The protocol requires that the doctors that do the transplant cannot be the doctors that declare the donor dead. No greater insult could exist. You mean, I say, I don't trust you to declare the patient dead because I think you will take a live patient because you're hungry, you need his organs. If that's the kind of person that you think he is, someone that you would level such an accusation, the first thing you have to do is get him out of the practice of medicine. In my opinion, that was an unnecessary insult, a shame of the profession that they allowed that rule to be established. But that rule is established today. The same people who declare the person dead cannot be part of the donation, part of the surgical team that harvests or does the transplant. The integrity of the medical profession is higher than any other profession.